Hello, beautiful people. Welcome once more to Gist Nigerian Artified Optimist. As usual, I'm your boy OV Mark. And if you're new to the channel, please subscribe by clicking the subscribe button just below the video. And if you're already a member, please, and even those who are new to the channel, please like the video by clicking the like button just below the video. Also, share the video using the share button below the video. Click the notification bell icon just beside the subscribe button so that every time we drop new videos, you can always get notifications about these new videos. Let's look at what's our number one gist for the day. Why I'm constantly under attack, Oshomole. So, All Progressive Congress, APC National Chairman Adams Oshomole said on Thursday that his stellar performance is the reason he has been under attacks and attempts being made to remove him from office. He goes on, "My report card is very clear. We have performed creditably," he said. Oshomole spoke at the presidential villa in Abuja when he led members of the party's National Working Committee on a New Year visit to President Muhammadu Buhari. Oshomole said the visit was also to congratulate the president on the successes so far recorded since his second term administration was inaugurated. The party chairman has faced a barrage of criticisms. Some governors are also scheming to get him out of office. The recent killing of four suspected kidnappers, allegedly of Fulani stock, along the Lokoja-Abuja highway by security agencies following a tip-off by vigilantes from Tawari community was said to have angered the militia, who in turn attacked the community. Another account has it sometimes last year, a headsman was allegedly killed and his body mutilated by suspected ritualists, for which his fellow headsmen pointed accusing fingers at the Tawari community and threatened a reprisal. But following persistent persuasion by the community head, Alhaji Yahaya Tawari, the headsmen lived with their host community in peace until a few days ago when they started moving out en masse. Efforts were said to have been made to pacify them, but the headsmen said their movement was a way of life, assuring that it bore no ulterior motives. Another eyewitness account puts the number of the dead at 23. The local government administrator, however, confirmed that 19 persons were killed. He described the incident as very unfortunate, but assured that efforts were on to return normalcy to the area. "I started planning Abuja bank robbery in October," banker. A customer care officer of a first generation bank, which was attacked by armed robbers last Saturday, Larry Ehizo, has stated that he began planning how to carry out the operation in October 2019. Ehizo, who recanted his earlier claim that a barman, Ernest Erwin, blackmailed him into carrying out the attempted heist, said he started nursing the idea, having monitored the security system and the processes in the bank. The customer care officer said, "Everything Ewim said is true. He didn't threaten me. I willingly collected his number and I called him and he said I should give him a few days. When I called him, I simply told him how they would go in, where they would see the riot policemen guarding the bank and how to disconnect the CCTV. On Friday night during our meeting, we had issues with getting a driver. When asked the motive for the crime, Ehizo simply stated, I was just greedy. I thought it was something simple that I could just pull off. I had taken time to study everything. I started thinking about it since October." The Federal Capital Territory Police Command had arrested the sixth member of the gang, Erwin, at his hideout on Wednesday. Wearing dreadlocks and dressed in a light blue denim jacket and matching blue jeans, the suspect sustained injuries in his legs. Blood oozed out of his right ear as he spoke to newsmen. The police had earlier gunned down a member of the gang, identified as Patrick, and arrested four others during the field operation. The FCT Commissioner of Police, Bala Sibroma, had on Tuesday paraded four gang members, including Ehizo, 30, as well as Timothy Joe, 21, Prince Will Obina, 24, and Elijah, David 19. Ewim, who doubles as a barman and disc jockey at the Ever Ready Hotel, Mpapi, explained that he organized the gang that carried out the Floyd heist at Ehizo's request. DSS parades suspect over fake President Buhari wedding video. The Department of State Service, DSS, on Friday paraded one Kabiru Mohammed of Dala Local Government Area, Kano State, over the fabrication and dissemination of a fake wedding video between President Muhammadu Buhari and two female members of his cabinet. The spokesman of the DSS, Dr. Peter Afunaya, who paraded the suspect at the headquarters of the service in Abuja, recalled that between August and October 2019, the fake video was widely circulated on the internet and on social media. He said the purported video showed the wedding of President Buhari, the Minister of Finance Zainab Ahmed, and the Minister of Humanitarian Affairs, Disaster Management and Social Development Sadia Umar Farouk, respectively. The DSS said on 11th October it received a petition and a formal complaint from the Minister of Finance Zainab Ahmed, who asked for an investigation on the video and the infographic with a view to identifying the person or group involved in the circulation of such material. Afnaya said the service succeeded in arresting Kabiru Muhammad, who has confessed to having initiated the creation and circulation of the defamatory video. He said the investigation is ongoing to determine the actual reasons and intent in creating and disseminating the false video, even though the suspect had confessed that he belongs to a political group in Kano State. He also warned Nigerians against the spread of false news on social media because victims of such fake news experience untold pains. Nigerian Air Force destroys Boko Haram facility in Sambisa. The Nigerian Air Force said it destroyed the Boko Haram logistics facility at Gujeri in the Sambisa forest area of Borno State. The NAF said the operation was executed through the Air Task Force of Operation Lafia Dole. NAF Director of Public Relations and Information, Air Commodore Ibikunle Daramola, made this known in a statement on Friday in Abuja. He explained that this was achieved in nighttime airstrikes executed on December 31st, 2019, pursuant to a series of intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance missions. Daramola said ISR missions identified some makeshift structures under some trees in the settlement that were being used by the terrorists to store fuel and other items for the maintenance of the vehicles. Accordingly, the ATF dispatched its combat helicopters to attack the location, recording devastating hits in the target area, resulting in the destruction of the storage facilities as well as other structures in the camp, he said. Daramola said NAF, operating in concert with surface forces, will sustain its efforts to completely destroy all remnants of the terrorists in the northeast. EFCC obtains court order to detain Sheu Sani for 14 days. A source in the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission has said that the anti-graft agency has obtained a 14-day detention order against the former lawmaker Sheu Sani. Sani is being accused of extortion by Sani Dauda, owner of ASD Motors. Following the new allegations raised by the complainant against the former senator, we have obtained a court order to keep him in custody for 2 weeks to enable us to carry out a thorough investigation into the case, the source said. The complainant said he gave Sani $10,000 in November 2019, which he said the former lawmaker promised to pass on to EFCC Chairman Ibrahim Magu. Dauda also accused Sani of asking for 4 million naira to be given to Chief Justice of Nigeria Ibrahim Tanko. The complainant claimed that Sheu Sani asked him to bring 4 million naira, which would be given to a judge by the Chief Justice of Nigeria to ensure that the case by one Abubakar against the ASD boss did not see the light of the day, the source added. Earlier, the EFCC had asked Dauda to prove his allegations against Sani for it to be able to prosecute the former lawmaker. According to sources, the senator was said to be working towards his release on bail after it emerged he was framed by Dauda. Sani is one of the most vocal critics of President Muhammadu Buhari's regime, an administration that has received backlash for its hounding of opposition figures and dissidents. Former Senate President Dr. Abubakar Bukola Saraki has said justice will prevail on the demolition of Ile Arugbo in Ilorin Kwara State. The property Ile Arugbo, which translates as Old People's Home, was brought down by the Kwara State government in the early hours of Thursday. The property belonged to late Olusola Saraki, the former Senate President's father. Saraki's reaction made public on his Twitter handle on Thursday reads, "Following the development this morning in Ile Arugbo, I want to commend the women and men, old and young, who displayed their affection, love and staunch support for my late father and the family. I appreciate the genuine support of the women and youth who stood firmly in the face of aggression and naked show of force. Your action throughout the night gave full expression to my belief that what Ile Arugbo represents to all of us is etched in our hearts. It goes beyond the physical structure. I'm happy that you were not intimidated as you stood your ground. This day will go down as the day you reciprocated the love and affection my father and family have for you. You have displayed a gesture of goodwill and passionate love. We assure you that justice shall prevail in a not too distant future," Saraki stated. Bandits on Thursday attacked an Abuja-bound train near Katari village in Kagarko, local government area of Kaduna State. Though the police were yet to confirm the attack, it was learned that the windows of coach SP12 attached to the train were shattered by bullets from the bandits' shooting. The police in Lagos on Friday arraigned a 39-year-old fake lecturer, Obi, in an Ojo magistrate's court in Lagos. Obi is charged with 3 counts of false pretense, fraud and stealing. The prosecutor, Inspector Simon Uche, told the court that the defendant committed the offense on November 1st, 2019 in Lagos. He alleged that the defendant presented himself as a lecturer from the University of Lagos to one Ikeduba. The prosecution also alleged that the accused lied to Ikeduba that he can secure admission into the university. According to the prosecution, the defendant requested and obtained 250,000 naira from the complainant to facilitate the admission process. The offense, he said, contravened the provisions of Section 78 to 187. 314 of the Criminal Law of Lagos State 2015. The defendant, however, pleaded not guilty to the offense. Magistrate A.A. Adesonya admitted the accused to bail in a sum of 100,000 naira with 2 sureties in like sum. He adjourned the case until March 4th for mention. The residence of a former Senate President, David Mark, in Otukpo Town, Benue State, was raised by fire on Thursday. According to eyewitnesses, the fire spread from a nearby bush bordering the fence of Mark's residence and burned to ashes 2 ambulance vehicles as well as over 15 motorcycles parked in the premises. It was gathered that domestic workers at the residence made frantic efforts to put out the fire without much success before the arrival of the state fire service. One of the domestic workers, who preferred anonymity, said, "We made every effort to quench the fire, but the more we tried, the more it continued to spread." Governor Emeka Ihedioha of Imo State has said he is unperturbed about the New Year prophecy of the spiritual director of the Adoration Ministry, Enugu, Reverend Father Ejike Mbaka. The Catholic priest had prophesied that the All Progressive Congress governorship candidate at the March 9th 2019 governorship election in Imo State, Senator Hope Uzodinma would become the governor of the state this year. The cleric has said, "I don't know how the manner the revelation will manifest, but no prophecy has ever been declared on this prayer ground without coming to pass. In spite of all what would happen this 2020, there is hope. In Imo State, there is hope." But the Imo State Commissioner for Information, Felix Ebilekwe, who spoke to correspondents in Owerri, the state capital on Thursday, dismissed Mbaka's prophecy. The Information Commissioner said neither the governor nor his aides and appointees were disturbed by the cleric's prophecy. Ebilekwe said, apart from the fact that Uzodinma coming a distant fourth at the polls, his petitions at the elections petitions tribunal and his appeal at the court of appeal against the declaration of Ihedioha as governor of the state by the Independent National Electoral Commission were summarily dismissed. He expressed optimism that the apex court would equally dismiss Uzodinma's appeal before it. Hence, there was no room for fresh evidence and prayers in the appeal. Ebilekwe advised Mbaka to face his spiritual calling and leave politics alone. The Edo State Governor, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, has linked the political tussle in the state to his administration's fight against warlords and non-state actors who hitherto controlled resources to the detriment of Edo people. Obaseki, at a meeting with Benin Elders Forum in Benin City, the Edo State capital, reassured that his administration would remain committed and focused on delivering the dividends of democracy to Edo people through his reforms and developmental projects. Lagos Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu has assured residents and motorists that the Agege-Pen Cinema flyover bridge will be completed and commissioned for use by June ending or early July 2020. The governor, who toured the project site on Friday in company of his cabinet members, said the bridge had reached 70% completion. He stated June/July date was a commitment given by the contractors. Sanwo-Olu also visited ongoing work at the first segment of construction at the Lagos-Badagry Expressway, which is open to motorists. The Agege-Pen Cinema flyover, which connects Oba Ogunji Road, where it takes off and drops off at Agumbiade on the other side, also has a railway underpass and three abutments splitting into adjoining streets all around Agege-Pen Cinema. The governor appealed to citizens and residents around the area to bear with the government a little bit more and to exercise more patience and cooperate with the contractor who has engaged many of them on site. The governor, who was accompanied by his deputy Obafemi Hamzat and some cabinet members, noted that the project will ease gridlocks and boost economic activities in the area. Human rights lawyer Mr. Femi Falana San on Thursday urged the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice Mr. Abubakar Malami San to ensure the release of the detained leader of the Islamic movement in Nigeria, Ibrahim El-Zazaki, and his wife Zinat. Falana, who made the call in an open letter, said the minister and the presidency never ceased to justify the detention of the couple, who have been in custody since December 2015. Malami had, while explaining why Ezezaki and his wife were not released on the Christmas Eve like Dasuki and Showore, said the federal government does not interfere with cases being prosecuted by a state government. But responding in his open letter to Malami on Thursday, Falana said, "Notwithstanding the pending criminal case in the Kaduna State High Court, your office and the presidency have not ceased to justify the refusal of the federal government to comply with the orders of the Federal High Court and the Kaduna State High Court." Falana also reminded the minister that on July 26, 2019, during his screening for reappointment as the Attorney General of the Federation, Malami told the Senate the failure to carry out the court orders by the Buhari regime in respect of El-Zazaki and others was based on national security. He urged the minister to ensure compliance with orders which had been issued by both the Kaduna State High Court and the Federal State High Court in respect of the couple. Florence Otedola, a Nigerian disc jockey, better known as Kapi, has admitted that men are scarce. The daughter of Femi Otedola, business mogul, has taken to Twitter to express shock as to why she is still single in 2020. According to her, "Me trying to figure out how it's 2020 and I'm still single," she wrote on Thursday. The post has since left many comments in its trail. She recently made headlines after her father described Samuel Perry, a comic actor better known as Brother Shaggy, as his son-in-law in reaction to comic video involving the duo. Liverpool broke the Premier League's all-time passing record after disposing of Sheffield United with ease on Thursday night. The Reds have swept all before them in the Premier League this year and are showing no signs of relinquishing their massive lead at the top. The 2-0 win over the Blades kept up their 13-point lead at the top of the Premier League, and they have now won their 19th game out of 20 this season. This is coming after Liverpool have emerged as the second team to take 58 points from the first 20 games of a new top-flight season. Goals from Mohamed Salah and Sadio Mane at Anfield secured their latest win, and in doing so, they broke a league record, according to Daily Star. Jurgen Klopp's men narrowly missed out on their first title in 29 years last season, but are now massive favourites to end that run. So this brings us to the end of the Gist on Gist Niger. As usual, keep supporting your boy, support Artified Optimist, support Gist Niger. Also, make sure you share the video, please. Click the like button, place a comment, and don't forget to click the bell notification icon so you can get more news anytime I drop them. Alright? As usual, please subscribe to the channel using the subscribe button below this video. Also, you can click the subscribe button right here, the circular icon that has my head showing in it. Also, you can click the two videos beside the subscribe icon showing on your screen right now, one to the left, one to the right. Thank you very much, guys. Adios. Have fun.